Hey, this is a follow-up to my story video. I made that video, like I said, because there may be new people to my channel, but also because, I don't know if you caught it, I think most people probably did, but what I was trying to say is, an illness, there was no point in my life where I got sick, and I know that's when my illness began, my myalgic encephalomyelitis with the orthostatic intolerance. The doctors have told me that they believe that it's from constant stress for too long a time and abuse. And they think that my body finally just shut down. Sorry, I'm cold here. And so that's what they believe caused me to get sick. And that's why I made my story for you guys, without coming out and saying that that's what I was doing. Well, and you know, a lot of stuff's happened, and I figured why not share your story and maybe people can learn from your mistakes or what have you. Now, the one thing that I did have that I find consistent with so many of us with these illnesses, these hidden chronic illnesses, is the hormone imbalance. I always did have the hormone imbalance. And the only chronic sickness that I had was strep throat at the same time every year until I got my tonsils out. But that was, I got my tonsils out before I graduated high school. I didn't end up getting sick and diagnosed till I was 28, and I went into my OBGYN thinking I was going into early menopause, and that's when I was diagnosed. I never even heard of the illness until then. Then when I says, what is that? And I says, and what do we do about it? Because mind you, I was a single mom with my own landscape company, and I was my only employee, and I was successful. I was doing good, and I was bodybuilding too. So I'm looking at him like, so what do we do about it, you know? And he goes, well, you go to bed for the rest of your life and rest because there is no cure. And I'm looking at him like, you're kidding, right? And he's like, no, I'm dead serious. And it's like, so years down the road, I ended up finally getting into Dr. Bateman. It takes a long time to get into her. And she diagnosed me with the same illness and then orthostatic intolerance and told me I had lost like 40% filling in my hands and feet at that time, and she did the tilt table test and stuff. So anyways, and since then my video only went to a certain time in my life. I quit dating 3 years ago because I looked at stuff, because I took the doctor's advice and decided I want to get the best quality of life that I can get. If I can't get better, I at least want to give myself the best quality of life and my kids. So I quit dating because dating was causing stress and stuff in all of our lives. It wasn't a positive. And I'm sure that's partially because of my past and, you know, habits and stuff. So, you know, because you get stuck and you have to retrain your brain to break the cycle. And, life has been a bit easier since I've gotten rid of the negative people in my life, the abusive people in my life. And I'm not saying when I was dating that they were abusive, but I have kept the people that are helpful in my life. My best friend Mark is the most helpful person ever, and I'm not getting rid of him for nothing. So, and we tried dating, but I just can't feel romantic about him, like I said. So, yeah. So now my life revolves around trying to get better. I have an 11-year-old, and I'm raising her. And my grandbaby and my two oldest live here. So, that's what my life revolves around. I do one small flower bed, and that's it. So, most days I'm not in bed all day, so that's good. That's quality of life. Yeah. So that's why I made that video, to try to show you guys how I got to the point of being sick. It doesn't give us any answers of what caused it, But the doctors believe with me, my body finally can take all the abuse and stuff and the constant stress, and so it finally just rebelled, and now here I am. And my doctors don't seem to have any hope of me getting better, but anyways, but that's okay. The illness makes sense to me as long as I'm able to do this kind of stuff. So as long as there's something positive coming out of it, then okay, as long as I'm doing what I can to make a positive imprint in life is what's important to me. So, all right, guys. Well, that's part two of my story. I hope that helps for any of you who didn't understand what I was trying to do with my story video. So I'll talk to you later. Bye.